Hey folks, my name is Jason Brian Santos, and I am the teaching elder and minister of Word and Sacrament at Community Presbyterian Church in Lake City, Colorado, a small mountain town of about 400 people in an 8,700-foot elevation and actually in the most remote county in the lower 48 states. I have been here for about 2.5 years, and prior to this, I was at the national office. I was worked at the Presbyterian Church, working in the Presbyterian Mission Agency, and there I oversaw the area of Christian formation, and this is what led me to be connected to, in part, to this curriculum. And delighted that we can explore the doctrine of Sabbath. For me, it was a topic that I really had never really dealt much with most of my life, but during my dissertation work at Princeton Seminary, where I was writing, doing a PhD in practical theology, focusing on youth, young adult spirituality. And while I was doing that, I was studying the community of Tizay in France, which is a small ecumenical monastic community of about 110 brothers. It's been around since about 1940. But I was studying the 100,000 pilgrims that visit that community every year and how they might sustain their understanding of spiritual formation that comes to them in the community after they leave the community. And I started exploring the doctrine of Sabbath and reframing Tizay as a Sabbath community. And it led me deeper and deeper into the doctrine of Sabbath, to the point that I realized that I never really have fully appreciated in most of my Christian life the doctrine of Sabbath. I'm delighted that that you are engaging in this material, and hope that some of my thoughts helps you shape your understanding of Sabbath and develop a new appreciation for it. To you about the idea of forgetting Sabbath today. And I know that probably seems like a weird idea, because there's so much language around honoring the Sabbath and remembering the Sabbath and keeping the Sabbath holy. And it's all of these verbs that are describing attentiveness to the Sabbath. And in this next section, what I'm actually going to ask you to do is to forget Sabbath. Now, let me pause for a moment and say, I don't want you to just totally forget Sabbath and erase it from your mind, as if you could. But I want you to actually forget your notions of Sabbath. For some, it may be walking in the woods and just sort of being in a peaceful place. For others, it could be lying in a hammock or just taking a break from what you normally do. And for some, in the whole sort of scope of Sabbath, it's a very legalistic thing. For a season, I lived in a Amish community, and on Sunday, it was forbidden to do most things. And you could see the Amish, they just sort of were hanging around, or they spent time in community, but they wouldn't do anything. They wouldn't do any work. They wouldn't do it. And they couldn't do any of those things. And so for some, it's a legalistic thing. For some, it's a sort of rest and recreation thing. And for some, if you're a pastor or you're a minister or you have a job on Sunday, sometimes we say, how do I celebrate Sabbath? Do I find it another way? Do I squeeze it in an hour here or an hour there? Do I take a vacation more as a Sabbath and just sort of accept the fact that I'm in a productive cycle of work every day of the week? And I guess for all of those conceptions of Sabbath, whatever they might be, I would invite you to let them go. When I first encountered Sabbath during the period when I was writing my dissertation, I discovered that Sabbath was something not what I expected. And for me, even going into writing the dissertation, I still had that traditional understanding of Sabbath, of what it was in my own context. And for me, it really was sort of, you go to church on Sunday and you have a family meal, and you spend some time with your family, maybe play a game or do some reading or watch a movie. It was just sort of family rec time. But over the course of writing a dissertation, I really sort of started to encounter the concept of Sabbath being something different. not being just Sunday afternoon, not just being a walk in the woods, and definitely not being left in a restrictive state of not being able to do anything. So when we forget Sabbath, we open the door to this new possibility. And if I could frame maybe that new possibility in just a phrase, it's the idea of letting go of those things that we do on a daily basis in exchange for not just rest, but holiness, things that are set apart, days that are holy. So instead of going to work every day of the week or going to school every day of the week or whatever you've done in your life every day of the week, a Sabbath, a time apart, is meant to be set apart as being holy. And not in the holy, the problem with our culture, I think, around the word holy is we often think, oh, something is holy, it means it's perfect, it's without flaw. Because we call God holy, we call God perfect, so we associate those two words together. But from a Hebrew context, the word holy means to set apart, something that is classified as being different, something that is saying this is different from all of this, and this, if this is this larger portion of your week, really the whole 6 days of it are given towards work or yard work or running errands or production or just constantly being busy and being inundated with so much of what our culture gives us, that holiness or being set apart or a Sabbath being set apart as being holy is really saying, I'm going to exchange all of the rhythms that define me in this world. And for this period, maybe it's a day, maybe it is only a half a day, or maybe it's a retreat or week or a weekend. But for this experience, for this holiness experience, for this Sabbath experience, I'm going to set aside those things I normally do. And I'm going to embrace a new way of being and dwelling. And for even in this activity of yourself, as you're sitting and studying, these are holy acts that you've set apart. You don't normally sit around studying doctrines, but for this moment, you are studying a doctrine and you're studying what it means to engage in these Christian practices. And that is a Sabbath act. That is a Sabbath practice of engaging in formation. So I want to invite you, as you approach this next lesson, to really think about it from that aspect of this is a holy, sacred Sabbath act, where I'm going to forget the things that I understood about holiness and Sabbath and being set apart, and I'm going to embrace this new understanding of what it means to have Sabbath be a part of my everyday and every week and every month and year Christian practice.